Hey guys, welcome back to another exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess, and today we are here to create another new logo design. This logo is in 3 dimension, which is forming a shape of alphabet H, where half portion of the H is on one side and the half is on the other side. In the middle, it is inclined inside, which is forming a depth. So to create this logo, we'll first create half portion of the edge using the rectangle tool and convert that shape into a symbol. Then after that, we'll use the 3D extrude bevel option to create a cube and we'll map that symbol inside that. Then after that, we'll convert that, expand that into object form. Then we'll tweak each surfaces separately. Then we'll fill up the color from the color palette. So let's begin the tutorial. So let's create the half portion of the shape. So I'll use the rectangle tool and left click your mouse button. Here a rectangle palette will appear where you can decide the width and height. I'll put around 100 by 100 and okay. So you got this nice square. I'll fill this up with certain color from here like that. And after that, next thing what I'll do is I'll just go to object path and split into grid, and what it will do is we can decide how many division you want on this. So I'll want 3 by 3, and you can preview that. Okay, and click okay. Now each surface is separate. Now what we'll do is we'll delete this portion from here and select everything, go to Pathfinder and combine it. Next, now this is one object. The next thing is we'll convert this into symbol. So I'll just select this, drag it to the symbol here and drop it there. Now name it like pattern, P-A-T-N, pattern, and click OK. Like, and now this is there. Now you can delete it from here. Now next thing is we'll create a 3D cube. So to create a 3D cube, I'll select this again rectangle, left click on my mouse button, 100 by 100 points and click OK. So it's create a cube. Square. Now what we'll do is we'll select that with the selection tool selected, go to effect, 3D extrude and bevel, and here the first thing we need to do is we have taken the dimension 100 by 100, so let's give the extrude depth also 100 points. Next, let's change all the values to 0 by 0 by 0 and let's preview it now. So you can see this is what it looks like. Now we'll increase the perspective to around 155. Okay. And we'll rotate this to around, let's say 20. Let's check it out. And let's control the rotation from here. So let's rotate, 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 and rotate it till 55 degree. Okay. And let's adjust the points here. Okay, that's fine. This. Okay, that's fine. Now we have got that basic shape here. Like perspective, I have given 55 degree, rest is 0, and this angle is 55, and the perspective is 155, and extrude depth is 100. Now next, what I will do is, I will need to map. So I'll first convert this into wireframe so that I can see the wires, and I'll go here, map one, and we can just select it from here. First, let's see which face is selected. We need one symbol here. So I'll just go here, select this, and you can see this is an under angle. So we need to rotate that. So just select this, rotate it with a shift press. You can rotate it to 90 degree angle like that. Now we'll go to next surface. We don't need that. This one. We have selected this face. Now we need one more symbol here. So I'll select this, and this is on top angle. So I'll just rotate it. Select, rotate it with a shift press, just rotate it, and now this is fine. And just before anything happens, let's check it out whether it's fit to the screen or not. Just scale this up a little bit and you can see that. Okay, let's check the other one. Okay, once you have checked that, click okay, and let's see this in now in plastic shade, and you can click okay now, and everything is now done. Let's zoom it in. Okay, fine. Now select this, go to object, expand appearance, go to object, expand it. Now right click and ungroup. Now select this, release clipping mask, select this, release clipping mask, and select that clipping mask and delete it. From here also select it, delete it. This is now separate. Now what we'll do is select everything, and let's use the shape builder tool to separate these surfaces. Now I'll just select one color from here, like this one, and let's fill up at here and here, and other color for the other one, like little lighter, they'll here and here. Now each piece is separate. Now we can select this, or maybe you can delete this off. We don't need this, and we have got all these pieces here at the background. If you move it, it's there. Now next thing is we'll just fill up with the particular colors. So let's select the colors, exact color which we need. So I'll select this with eye picker. I'll select this color. I'll select this one with eye picker. With shift and alt press, I select this color. V selection, this one. Let's do some adjustment first. So what we need here is we need some inclination here, like creating a depth. So I'll just first select this and just place it around here where you can see the points are intersecting. In the same way, select this and place it here in such a way that the point intersect here. Now other, select this and place it here. Select this, place it here. So once you have done that, I'll just select this and arrange it to front. Next, select this, and with the eye picker, or maybe just select one, and with the eye picker, with the shift and alt press, just select this color. V for selection, I for eye picker, with the shift and alt press, select this color. In the same way, select this, with the eye picker, select this color. Select this, with the eye picker, select this color. Let's check it out. Okay, that's fine. Now next thing is let's do the adjustment. So I'll select this and G for gradient. You can see that. Now I'll just apply the gradient color in a particular order. So we need some dark here and lighter here. So I'll just do that from here, drag till here. Okay, now select this G from here till there. So lighter here, darker here. In the same way, select this G, lighter here, darker there. In the same way, G, lighter here, darker there. So let's check it out. Okay, everything is now good. Now next thing is we need to add these details. So first let's create this one. So to create that, I'll just duplicate this one more. Control C, Control F to paste in the front. Now I select a rectangle and draw out one like this. Let's check it out. Okay, I'll just make this into stroke. And okay, that's fine. I'll just scale this a little bit here. And now selecting this, select this, and selecting both this, go to Pathfinder and subtract, like intersect, and this will be separated out. Okay, select that portion and make it fill. Okay, then after that, let's change the color. With the eye picker, I select this color. Shift and alt press, I select that color. Now once you have done that, you can see that we have given that small piece here detail. Now next thing is we need to add that. So to add that, I'll use the ellipse tool and create a one big circle, this much, and stroke. Then after that, I'll just bring this around here and check it out whether which angle I need to give, like a little bit of here. We can just scale this up if it's not giving that shape, and just check it out by placing there. And with the arrow keys, just move here and there to check to place in proper area. Okay, once you find that site, select this, Control C, Control F, bring, arrange it to front, and select this also, both, and intersect. And only this piece will be left. I'll fill that up with white color for now. And let's apply the gradient color. This is our gradient color. So I'll just select this with the eye picker, shift and alt press, and here is the gradient color, G for gradient. And let's do the adjustment from here till here. Here's the lighter, and here there is opacity 0. So if you want to see the gradient option here, this is, and if I select, click on that, this is the setting which you have given here. I have given both the colors white, but here it's 100% opacity, here is 0. So that's giving that nice effect, giving a nice effect, like here it's null, and here you can see the opacity. And the opacity value which I given is 30° for overall. Now let's check it out. Okay, I'll just scale this up, and if we need any little later adjustment, we can do that. So let's check it out. What more we need here? We've given that. Okay, we need to this shadow. So we will create that using the pen tool. So I'll use the pen tool and draw out from here around here till here, one at here and here and here. Now I fill that up with some dark color from here. Okay, and I'll reduce the opacity to around 50. Let's check it out. Okay, now that's fine how it's looking. Okay, this is what we needed. If you want to do adjustment a little more, I can just select this with a direct selection tool. I just select the point and just drag it down a little bit, giving it some perspective view like that. And I can increase the opacity to 60 so that we can change see this effect. Let's give it to 50 and let's do some changes with the color, like from here, 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 which fits best. We can put that up. Okay, that's fine. That's good. Now we have given that effect, we have given all this details, and last thing we are left with is the text. So I'll use the text and type out Hadal with a caps lock on, Hadal, Hadal. And the font which I'm using right now is Perpetua Titling Empty. So I'll just select it from here. You'll find it on the text palette. And the font is light. It has got two, a bold and light. I'm using light. And the font size is too huge. I'll reduce it to, let's check it out. And let's give some effect here, like going to character. I'm putting some distance around 1560. Okay. And let's place it here and let's increase the font according to the logo size like that. Okay, and I'll just increase it a little bit. Okay, that's fine. Now once I have given that, I'll just place it in proper place. And the color with the eye picker, I'll select this color and here we apply the color. Now if we check it out, we have finally finished the logo design. We have given all the details which we needed for the logo and finally we have completed this design. So finally we have completed our logo. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. For business inquiry, you can check out the email address on the screen and also you'll find it in the description below. Thank you.